Okay, we're back. Let's head out. I have no idea why they're attracted to some people and, well, others not. At a small split in the trail, a few fighters stopped to speak with you, each carrying a single pack. "We recognize this place," one man says. "Spent several years here with some kin. If they're still around, we have to warn them of what's coming. With luck, we'll find you again in less than a week." You know what? Let's send them off with extra supplies. They did good to us, so let's just be generous with them. If that's all you're taking, you may never make it, you say. Grabbing a few items from a supply wagon, you strap the additional provisions to their backs. "Search for family instead of food," you say with a smile. The men clasp wrists with you before departing. For three supplies, 10 renown is very good. Complaints of Raffenswarter's excessive drinking have resurfaced. This time, the man stumbled over some tent ropes, pulled the snagged caravans through a campfire, well, snagged caravans through a campfire, nearly setting a supply wagon aflame. Clansmen put out the fire, both the wagon and Raffenswarter's leg before leading to you. "This man drinks nothing but water from now on," Raffenswarter groggily agrees, slurring his way through promises to quit being such a nuisance. Many of the onlookers snort or roll their eyes, but go back to their business. Somehow, you Dan will be along before Raffenswarter manages to find another drink, whether you allow it or not. "There's Frostfeller." "Dredge!" shouts a man from the back of the caravan. It's Raffenswarter, the unabashed drunk, staggering toward you, looking not entirely sober. He screams again, pointing to trees in the distance. Fear races through the caravan as fighters pull up their weapons. Scouts return with no sightings, and furious men surround Raffenswarter. "Let your clansmen deliver justice." A swift and brutal beating befalls Raffenswarter, one that leaves him begging for mercy. The next time he is offered mead, the man shies away in fear. As for the rest of the caravan, everyone seems pretty satisfied.
"Once a strong, thriving city, the walls of Frostvetter now just keep the howling winds at bay. With luck, they'll hold out against Dredge as well."
Yep, there's Frostfettler. I missed the T when I first pronounced it. You jostle through fallow crowds of sunken faces who appear just as though they've been freezing in front of Frostfettler for days. The gates are closed. You come to a stop at the bottom of the hill. This is not looking good. Why are there so many people in the fields? We can't stay outside in the open like this. Oddly finds you amongst the many refugees. "Rook, I just talked to some of the women here. Nobody is being let into the city." "Why?" "It's overrun with Farl from Blotspalker, Greyhorn, people from Bitra, all the nearby villages. The Dredge are everywhere. And the chieftain of Frostfettler has locked himself in his great hall. That's when they closed the gates. When the Dredge come, these hills will turn red. We have to get in there." "I want to know more about what's going on in there. I see lots of people gathered around the rest houses and the gates. We could find out what they know. How would we get in, anyway? They closed the gate." "I can get that gate open. Let's see if there is any other way before we start breaking down gates." "I wasn't going to break it. Just push really hard." That's so you, Ivor. That's pretty much a Varl thing. You know, push hard enough and things will fall over. Though not all Varls are like that. Maybe that's just the generalized idea. Force it open. You approach the gate, where hundreds of people have gathered. In the trodden, bloody space in front of the doors, several pincushion bodies lie unclaimed, as though they simply belonged there. Archers up the walls make it clear that nobody will be getting in. Men and women follow intermittently call for mercy and reason when they're not flinging stones and curses. Ivor, do you really expect to push these gates open? I'm willing to try, grunts Ivor. Despite sizing up doors and look like they could hold back an army, and when men start shooting arrows and start pouring out to stop you, then you kill them, he says. You're not sure this is the most sound plan. We're not doing this. This is a terrible idea, you say. We don't even know how many are in there. Ivor folds his arms. He seems almost relieved that he didn't have to live up to his earlier boast. Let's find out more from the crowd. We spend an hour talking to different people who all have the same story. A couple days ago, the chieftain shut himself in, closed the gates, and refused any more refugees. They've got huge stores of supplies in there too, adds one man. They're just hoarding them. Aegon pulls you aside. I was following the outside of these walls, he says, and there's a water passage we could squeeze through, I think. Not the whole caravan, but if a handful of us get in, we might open the gates from the inside. Well, let's leave the gates for now and try something else. You leave the crowds and head back down the hill. There are lots of people gathered around the rest houses, says Onleaf, pointing. Maybe we can find help there. Or at least make ourselves useful. Well, making ourselves useful is better than nothing. You spend a whole day at the rest houses. Everyone gives you the same story, the chieftain, blah blah blah. There are a lot of wounded here, says Alette. We could help them. Ego pulls you aside. Blah 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 blah. Let's tend to the wounded. Alette and Onleaf spend the day along with others in your caravan treating wounds, most of which came from the archers at the gates. I overheard from one woman that the city has been sending carts with food around, Onleaf tells you. Could be a way in, Ivor replies. Next time they send a cart, we bring it back in. Onleaf protests. Aside from leading to a fight, it would probably mean no more food for the refugees. We'll wait and confront them. Keep your sword down until we need it, you tell Ivor. We'll make a deal unless they're looking for a fight. Early the next day, you spot another cart leaving the gates of the city, after they've thrown their scraps to the refugees you approach. Stop. My friend wanted to talk with you. It's not what I wanted. Oh, I think I can guess why. Yeah, and you're wearing a helmet. You know, taking from the insights that Tryggvi has, we shouldn't trust this guy. If we knew there were more fighters in Varl out here, Echo might have brought you in the city. Who's Echo? He's in charge up there. In charge of what? Better let him explain. I don't think so. We're done here. Onuf shakes his head and gets the cart moving again. They head back to the gates. What was that about? At worst, we could have taken them. Didn't sound right. There's something going on up there. Then I think we better dig in and figure out what to do next. I think you're right. Little did they sleep. So from Frostfettler back to, well, the other side, the Shriveners. Although now it shows the image of Haken. Back to Vedderfell. Haken, we're back. I was able to get about as many warriors from the Strand as you wanted, and more weapons, extra supplies too. You perk up, just now realizing Mogr has been talking to you. Since Volgnir died, everyone has been looking up to you to make decisions. It's exhausting. Haken? I heard you. I was saying the Varl we sent to Strand have returned. The governor gave us most of what we wanted. Good enough. Most resistance from the governor? Some. I don't think he was happy about us buying his fighters using his own money. He also insisted we take on a lackey of his to watch over his property. A man named Eric.
Eric? I met him. He seemed competent enough.
Regardless, the governor will have to get over it unless he wants Dredge crawling through his streets. We've put down every slag that has wandered through here while you were gone. Enough flapping of mouth, then. You sure that wound has healed, Luden?
I agree. Enough has already gone wrong. If something happens to the prince on a mission of peace, the alliance would rot. Or worse.
Luden makes his own decisions. We would only be made to do this again later, and I will not suffer at all a second time. Either take us through the Wandering Roan or do your job and slaughter some dredge. Luden turns abruptly with a scowl. He stamps back to his ring of tents and followers.
Wandering Road's not an option with this many. I could crush that boy's skull with one hand. If Luden won't be deterred, you'll have to deal with it. Don't let Luden get to you.
Let's go. I'm sick of looking at this dump.
What do I tell the warriors, Haken?
Tell them we cover the mountainside in dredge bodies.
Good. Give the word and we'll set off.
Well, we've got people to talk to, so we might as well. Let's talk to Ubin first. I think that was what his name is.
You knew him well, didn't you?
Yeah. Volgnir?
No.
Well, I don't know. I remember him. Always rushing around with some important business, but I never knew him. Never got a chance to talk much.
Longer than I did in that case.
I suppose so. When he spoke, Varl listened. I knew that.
I could use help there. The Shrivener leans back, considering the sentiment.
I've seen worse. They respect you for your ability to swing an axe. They need to respect you for your actions. But you're not talking to the right Varl. Morgan's got some skill there. Most I can do is hold a quill.
What are you always putting down in that journal?
How do you mean? What do I write? I write what happens.
They've got a banner in Aberrang for that, you know.
You mean the long banner?
Yes, the Menders wove up something that writes its own history.
You want my opinion? I don't trust it.
No?
It tells a broad story. I think there's some value in the narrow. Whose story does it write? Mine? Theirs? Lune's?
Gods forbid.
Heh, you relic. The gods have been dead a long time.
Oh, have they?
Old habits, I suppose.
I heard you were terror in your day.
Do you know how old I am?
Dare I ask?
I'm competing, you know. Nobody knows how old we Varl can get.
Naturally. There is one by the name of Snorri. He's got a few years on me. Just hunkers in Grofheim collecting rhyme. Bastard might actually beat me. Another one named Krumer is close, I think. But the adult son of a bitch still welcomes a fight. He'll probably be off before I am, though. The Shrivener gestures around him as if to remind you of this current situation. You chuckle. Anyway, point is, what difference does it make? I'm just a delivery baron for the Drondir now. Can't remember half of what I'd done. Hence the journal? Hence. Don't take fancy on my behalf, Hawken. Okay, I won't. What do you suppose happened to the sun? Gods, how should I know? Never seen something like this before. Are you worried? Some of the Varl in the caravan think the world's coming to an end. Others think the best thing that could happen. No more black months. I'll take it if it's the end. I'm ready. What about the rest of us? To the depths with you. Get some rest. Always more marching to do. I've hoofed more hills than a horse born with a grudge. Don't worry about me. Alright, let's talk to Mulgar here. I'd asked how you're dealing with Fogner's dead, but I already know the answer. Do you? Steady old Mulgar, which is good. I knew most of these, Varl, but they're not under my command. They came to follow Vognir. Tell you the truth, I don't want to be in your position either. Anything you can even tell me about the caravan? Throw together this many Varl, half of them want to hit each other, the rest want to be left alone. Anyone I should keep an eye on? There's a couple of clan leaders trying to show off for each other. Not a big deal. I've got it under control. The fighters we just got from Strand aren't bad, but they're unruly. Give it a few days. And there are a few moaning about fighting for you instead of Vognir. Those are the ones to worry about. What about Luden's men? They don't want to hear anything from me, I know that. Any problems? Could be. Luden's pet Varl is named Bursi. I'm not sure where he came from or what his deal is. Bastard knows how to fight, but there's something I don't like about him. His girl in red is scary too. Ursa. She's probably the best fighter Luden's got, to be honest. I've overheard some of the Varl call her the Witch. Why? The flaming arrows, I think. It's a good trick, but the fire upsets our Varl more than the dredge. Still doesn't make sense. Witch? They're not scholars, Hawken. I think they're mostly just afraid of her. That makes more sense. Don't let her find out. Haven't you ever wanted to be in command? More than I am? Any more rope and I'd hang myself. I doubt that. I forget. You weren't around back then. At one point I had more rope. I hung myself. So no, I'm not interested in command. It's all yours. Thanks. You think we're walking into a death trap? If there's many Varl? No. We should be alright. Things could get rough though. I don't like being the one to send Varl to their deaths. I like worrying about myself, and that's the extent of it. Who would have expected Vognir to drop like that to a couple of slag? I'm still wondering about what happened. He had hundreds of dead slag to his name. I don't get it. Just happens sometimes. No big moment. I'm sure it surprised him even more than us. Although, I have to wonder. Yeah, never mind. Anyway, I'll worry about the warriors. You worry about not doing something stupid. That's asking a lot. What were you holding back about Vognir? I'd rather not say, Hawken. Why not? It's the kind of thing that gets stuck in your head, and you need a clear one. It's better if you let me worry about it. That sounds important. Tell me. How did Vognir die? He ran into Dredge. Wasn't expecting it. When we found him, he was lying face down, like he was struck from behind. Did he really get taken down by some random slag? Who else was there? You think Luden? He probably didn't, but... Damn it. We should keep an eye on that bastard. See if you see anything, tell me. I will. Let's get back to it. Let me know if you need anything else. I will. Alright, gonna pause here and then we'll get back to it. One moment.